So this is Night Hacking today at Java Day Tokyo. And I have Heather VanCura. How are you, Heather?
Hi, Yolande. I'm doing well. Thanks for interviewing me today.
Thanks for talking to us today. So you have some news from the JCP. Is that what you want to talk about today?
Yes. So
what's new?
What's new? So as you know, we've been working on the JCP.next initiative for the last several years, working on responding to the needs of the Java developer community as we evolve the JCP program itself, the governance and structure of the organization. So we've had a couple of steps along the way over the years, and this month we had the latest iteration release as part of the JCP.next effort, which was through JSR 364. So JSR 364 went final, which is very exciting because we've been working on it for a couple of years now with the executive committee. I've been working as the spec lead, and the JCP executive committee serves as the expert group for that. And we've been looking at the issue of how can we get more participation and membership in the JCP. So broadening our JCP membership and bringing more participants into the JCP. So we started that off a couple years ago.
So when you say members, I mean, what kind of members, right? This is always the little community side of me that says, okay, so just companies or more?
No, actually we started looking at the issue of how can we get, it started out as an individuals working group. So it started out of that, looking at that question of how can we get more individuals engaged with the JCP. Mm-hmm. And we broadened it after a little bit of time in the working group to be how can we look at all of the barriers facing any group of members in the JCP. So we broadened it to include individuals, but also Java user groups and corporations. So we looked at it from across the board because several years ago we allowed some changes to enable all groups to be able to participate, open source groups, Java user groups, companies, as well as individuals. So that's been possible for a while, but mm-hmm. We're looking at, you know, how can we get even more of each of those types of members to participate. So that was what we did with JSR 364. We called it broadening JCP membership, and it really was beyond the individuals to look at all types of participants we see in the JCP and looking at how we can engage more of them. So that was what we did. And I think we came up with some interesting solutions. And so we introduced basically different levels of membership for different types of people.
Okay.
So traditionally, we've just had one type of membership for JCP members. So we introduced some new levels of membership. I think I have a chart that shows you. Well, it's frozen. My computer's frozen. We just got this displaying on the screen. My computer is frozen. Well, I can tell you what the levels are since it's not going anywhere. So we have the full membership, which mm-hmm. we've had always, and we eliminated the fees for that level of membership, which used to have a fee. So that was a barrier for some people, the fee. Mm-hmm. And then we introduced a user group membership, so a partner membership, we call it. So
you had already like two user groups that were part of the committee, right?
In the last couple years, for a while we had three Java user groups that were part of the executive committee.
Oh, right.
But every year we have elections for the EC. So right now we have two Java user groups who are members of the executive committee, London Java Community and So Java.
Right. Yeah. So will they be again like elected or how?
Well, that's up to the membership. So every year the members elect serves on the EC. So they have been on the EC, both of them, for quite some time.
Right.
So it's hard to say, you know, what will happen in the elections. You never know what the outcome is going to be. But we'll continue to have, you know, Java user groups able to run for seats on the executive committee. I just can't say who's going to win the seats on the executive committee.
And how many seats are there?
Oh, we have 25 seats on the executive committee.
Oh, okay. So, and how many for the community, for user groups?
We don't have designated seats for user groups. User groups run alongside any other member.
Oh.
Although, you know, the community is, you know, self-selecting. I think it's pretty representative of all the different types of people. We have vendors, we have people kind of represented across different spaces. We have some, a couple of financial industry representatives, some end user companies like Twitter, for instance, you know, some open source group. We have Eclipse serves on the executive committee, two Java user groups, a couple of individual Java developers.
Okay.
So it's pretty well-rounded representation, but there isn't a quota for number of user groups or number of individuals.
So that's a call to the community. You can be a lot more engaged with the JCP if you want to.
Yeah, so see, but what we did different for the user groups with this iteration of the JCP, with JCP version 2.10, is some user groups do not want to join as full members because it's 11-page agreement. So we introduced a partner agreement, which is a one-page agreement, and it makes more sense if your user group is more like a meetup type of group where, you know, you're not in a legal entity, that where it really makes sense for you to sign an 11-page document to join as a member. So you can join as a partner member, and it's a one-page document, and, you know, it deals more with the types of things that user groups do in supporting the JCP community versus something that's more targeted towards a legal entity as the original agreement was written. So that's one new thing that we have. And then for individuals, sometimes it was difficult for individuals to join the JCP because it required, if their if their company didn't want to join that they work for, they have to go get permission from their employer. So we introduced an associate level membership that individuals can sign. Again, it's a smaller agreement, one page, and it doesn't require their employer to sign. And they can sign up to be contributors to JSRs to get that recognition if they're willing to spend some time and download the latest drafts, provide comments, run tests against the early access builds, you know, issue comments in the JIRA, the issue trackers. You know, they're free to do that, as anyone is, without becoming a member, but this gives them actually some recognition. So if they sign up as associate members, they're eligible to nominate themselves and serve as contributors on their JSR that they're passionate about.
Okay. Wow, that's big.
Yeah, so
we've introduced
a couple new memberships, and it makes things, you know, a little bit more.
Go ahead. Continue. I'm just going to put us back on the.
Yeah. So we have a couple different charts we introduced on the website, because then it becomes a little bit, it's a little bit simpler if you just say one type of membership, but it was limiting to some people. So this, you know, creates, you know, three types of members. You have a partner member, full member, or an associate member. Where before it was just members, and then you're a different type of person that's always, you know, signing in the same agreement.
Right.
But now we have multiple choices for the one that fits best for you. So there's a flow chart that I was going to show you, but it's on jcp.org.
Okay.
Yeah.
If you go to
jcp.org and click becoming a member on the left-hand side, that's one of the first thing you'll see is the flow chart that will start asking you questions about, you know, your situation. If you work for a company, if your employer is a member already, how to participate as a representative of that company, or if for whatever reason your employer doesn't want to join, you know, how to go about getting the appropriate approvals there and signing up for the right membership. So,
do you?
So under JCP info, click on Get Involved on the left-hand side.
I'm going to show the screen then.
Oh, okay. All right. Get Involved, becoming a member.
I see.
Yeah. Kay. So there's the three different memberships.
Going to have some live feed. Okay. Let's see what we can do here.
Okay.
There we go.
All right.
So you can.
Okay, so here we go. Up at the top, you see we have got three memberships: associate members, partner members, or full members, like I was discussing. And then there's the flow chart. So commercial organization, nonprofit. When nonprofit, we're saying that's specifically for Java user groups, but there are other nonprofits who are members of the JCP, but it's primarily Java user groups. We have a few like Apache and Eclipse who are nonprofits that don't fall into that category of Java user groups, but we have about 50 Java user groups who are already members. So this is just a different agreement for them. Partner membership. And then for individuals, that's where there's a few more choices. So individuals can either participate as part of their employer's membership, so they can do it that way, or they can participate as a full member and have their employer sign the employer contributor agreement, so then there's the full member, or they can join as an associate member, in which case they would not require any employer signature. They would sign themselves up as an associate member, and then they'd be eligible to serve as a contributor on a JSR. And the other thing we did for the associate members is we introduced two of those seats on the executive committee where I told you we had 25 mm-hmm. seats. So two of those seats are for associate members to vote on. So in theory, those seats would be represented by people who are serving the interests of the associate members. So
I see.
Yes. Only full members, though, are eligible to serve on the EC, but they would need to designate themselves as they feel like they are best served to be representing the needs of associate members in the JCP. Okay. So we'll have our first election this year this way with under the new membership levels, and that will start. Nominations open in September, but the ballot will be in November. So we'll find out in late November who's going to be serving on the executive committee for the next term, and we have our elections every year. But for right now, we need people, you know, who haven't joined the JCP before for whatever reason, felt, you know, it was too complicated or agreement wasn't there that fit their needs, that they take another look and see if they can find a membership agreement that fits well for their situation. Mm-hmm. And the other thing that we did, as I mentioned, we eliminated the fees, but we also introduced electronic signatures. So now, rather than having to deal with PDF scans, it's an actual electronic signature software workflow, so that makes things a little bit easier as well.
So anybody in the world can actually join?
Yeah, everybody can join. So it's still an option if they want to do offline okay. membership, of course, but most people have been asking for this electronic signature for some time, so that's another thing that we introduced this month to make it easier for people to join.
Wonderful. So yeah. You just announced it, right? A couple of
yes,
weeks ago.
Yes, May 10th or 12th. Okay. So, yeah, so about a week and a half ago, okay. 2 weeks. Yeah, it's relatively new. So we've gotten actually some really good feedback about it. So encourage more feedback. And okay, we're looking to, you know, really kick off a membership drive here over the next 3 months.
How do you get more feedback?
Feedback. If you want to send feedback, you can send it to admin@jcp.org, or we actually did this work, as I mentioned earlier, as a JSR. So the JSR number is 364 because we use the process to change the process. If you go to JSR 364 on jcp.org, there is a link under transparency that says public discussion. So you could send it to the observers mailing list there. So you can send it in that way. We make sure everybody can see it, or if you feel more comfortable just, you know, wanting to send in your feedback to my office, you can send it to admin@jcp.org.
Cool.
And we can address any questions or respond to your feedback.
Excellent. So
yes.
Are you presenting today
on this? On this topic, I am not. I touched on it briefly in the keynote earlier this morning at Java Day Tokyo. So, I don't have a breakout session about this topic, but we are going to be discussing it during the panel discussion at 6:30 tonight as part of the Java Day Tokyo agenda. So I think that's being captured in video as well. So we'll be having a 45-minute panel discussion about community, and most of the topics that I'll be discussing are around, you know, how we're trying to get more participation into the JCP, and this latest version of the JCP is one of the latest things that we've been working on. So I'll be talking about it.
Excellent. Well, thank you, Heather.
Okay,
thank you
thanks for
the great news.
Taking the time.
And for the great work, because obviously that's hard work. So
yes, thank you.
Thank you for talking to us.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Bye.